Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bassam Haddad, and I'm the host as well as participant in this 11th emergency teach-in titled The Most Moral Army in History, Celebrating the IDF. Thank you all for joining us and for taking the time to learn even more than we have already learned and witnessed about the many aspects and dimensions of how infinitely moral the Israeli Defense Forces are. Hands down, if they leave you any, there are no words to describe the grandeur of the most moral army in the history of the world. The mere mention of the acronym IDF, I have goosebumps, guys. Hang on. The mere mention of the acronym IDF induces tears of moral joy as the images of its daily moral actions grace our screens. Image after image, blown up body after mutilated body, the name Israeli Defense Forces will enter history as the epitome of refined humanity and facial mutilation from white phosphorus. How can you go wrong with a state like Israel? A funding state like the US, and a historically moral state like Germany. Just think of this trio and their past unending moral orgies. The massacres, the destruction, the extermination, the killing, the ethnic cleansing, the displacement, the destruction, the invasions, and the final glory of exquisite genocidal intent and execution. Yet, the IDF emerges as the most moral of them all. Join our illustrious panel of experts, Sinan Antoon, our cultural landscape expert, Adel, our media landscape expert, and myself, Bassam Haddad, our social science expert, in bringing to you this 11th emergency teach-in. We are the hosts of the show Three Arabs And, which will likely never be recorded. Let me start by saying that on any given day, you turn on your television or Twitter feed or X feed or Instagram, what have you, and you watch the endless ethical and morally refined beauty of the IDF. And in order to put us all in the mood, we're going to go through a short video that puts things in perspective for all of us.
Triumphatori, Marcus Lamartus.
right. Adel, as our media landscape expert, can you please shed light on the grandeur of the IDF and its moral fortitude?
Thank you so much, Bassam. It's extremely difficult to follow this video because of all the incredible work, moral work that's done in this video. So I just wanted to take a moment to acknowledge the outstanding work in morality that's been done by the IDF. But as media scholars, we examine representations, portrayals, and depictions that help us understand phenomena. And I really appreciate your invitation, Bassam. Yes, I know it's very, very easy to be swept away by the clickbait fetish around the IDF, especially as being a sex cult. But it's very important not to reduce the IDF's hard-earned work beyond swimsuit calendars. Such more immorality obfuscates the incredible ethical work and the modesty and the mighty maiming machine that is working day in and day out to uphold morality in the land. For today's topic, we honestly cannot get enough media displays of the IDF's morality. Western media coverage has been absolutely exceptional. Frankly, I mistook yesterday's reporting on Gaza on CBS with Nickelodeon. To glean more insight about the conduct of the IDF, and especially their overarching moral objectives, I turned to Disney's most loved colonial white savior family favorites like Pocahontas, Atlantis, and Tarzan. The IDF's work is very much in line with that. But for round-the-clock incisive coverage of the IDF's operations in Gaza, I suggest you turn to Paw Patrol, CNN, in fact. Look no further than CNN, who have been actively depicting the Israeli military as a Paw Patrol routine mission. In fact, rubble is certainly not just on the double, on the triple and the quadruple in this case. In fact, the IDF is so moral, we should recruit them to raise our children for us. For example, is your child finicky with their food and won't eat their broccoli? The IDF will have them begging for raw onions. Tired of your children wasting their juice and milk? The IDF will have them drinking out of the toilets. Your kids always complaining about boredom? The IDF will have them begging for a moment of peace. Are your kids lying to you? The IDF's advanced techniques will have them volunteering the truth even if you don't want it. Your kids throwing tantrums that makes you regret even having them? Well, the IDF will make sure it's their very last tantrum. Concerned about your children's laziness? The IDF will have them running around nonstop in a high-octane game of hide and kill. Are your kids bullies? The IDF will outbully them and turn them into traumatized, pacified, soulless beings. Are your kids exhibiting suicidal tendencies? Well, the IDF will take them and you out of your collective miseries in one fell swoop. So let's consider that as a possibility. As media scholars, we also examine representations and portrayals, not just in the contemporary moment, but in historical documents across eras and time periods. When exploring this specific question about the morality of the IDF, and despite the extraordinary and unparalleled levels of morality exhibited by this most ethical army, I'm sorry to reveal to everyone's chagrin. Actually, I'm very, very sorry. The IDF simply does not measure up against other record holders. The force publique, for instance, under the command of King Leopold II of Belgium, who euphemistically called his own personal colony, the Congo Free State, thanks to the extraordinary morality of the force publique, the Congolese population declined by estimates of 6 to 9 million due to violence, famine, reduced birth rate, and epidemic disease brought on by the force. The colony was granted to Leopold with the purpose of improving the lives of the people, and he got to work right away. The force publique is credited with having killed or contributed to the death of nearly half of the population of the Congo. Congolese men and women were systematically flogged and raped by soldiers. For the FP, soldiers often cut off human hands, either as trophies or to show that bullets were not wasted on them. They often cut off the limbs of children to punish parents who were viewed as not having worked enough on the rubber plantations. Do you still think the IDF is the most moral army after all? Well, then meet Genghis Khan, the ruler of the Mongol Empire of Northern Mongolia from the year 1206 to 1227 AD. Okay, so the siege and attack on the city of Merv in the modern day Turkmenistan is eerily similar to the moral siege and attack on Gaza by the IDF, where in both cases, virtually wiping out two metropolises off the map by murdering, pillaging, and wrecking everything in sight. The IDF still has some catching up to do with Genghis Khan, who is said to have killed somewhere between 700,000 and 1.3 million people in just this attack alone. He ordered 4,000 girls in the Mongolian city of Oirat to be repeatedly raped by his soldiers and the girls' families be forced to watch. In his army's attack on Baghdad, where almost a million people were said to have been killed, children were thrown in the mud and countless died of fear, hunger, and disease. So while the IDF is on track to become the most moral army in history, they have a little bit more mass annihilation to earn this accolade. All right, so the IDF isn't the goat of military morality. Not everyone can be Messi, Ronaldo, Jordan, or LeBron. But let's cut them some slack. They're doing their best. They should at least be acknowledged for their history of morality. In fact, the IDF comes from a long esteemed lineage of moral militias operating in Palestine. The predecessors of the IDF are the Haganah, the Irgun, Lehi, and the Palmach. Just a short visit to the Haganah Virtual Museum, which you can visit online, will have you building an altar for this most ethical army in your own home. Unlike most secure platforms, this virtual museum is only accessible with a simple one-step verification to prove that you are not human. So, despite being a terrific museum, it misses the mark by humbly and modestly avoiding the most exquisite moral work of the Haganah in the areas of assassination, terrorism, and even castration. Not to be outshunned by the Haganah, the Irgun and Lehi, Zionist militias, also forebears of the Israeli Defense Forces, have their own record of morality, from such notable actions as the Deir Yassin massacre, where bodies of Palestinians were piled and burned in mass. Sounds familiar? Or the shelling of Jaffa by the Irgun in 1948. Their objective was to break the spirit, quote, this is according to Benny Morris, break the spirit of the enemy troops and to cause chaos among the civilian population in order to create a mass flight, end quote. Of course, incredibly familiar to us today from Gaza. So a fantastic lineage and genealogy there. In fact, the morality of each of these IDF militias is evident from their logos and emblems. The Haganah has a beautiful shimmering sword that is kindly and gently embraced by an olive branch, indicating the reluctance to use force, but also the way in which force is very much at one with peace and generosity. The Palmach, for example, shows a sword between two wheat stems, indicating that when the sword is not being used to kill, it is actually a sickle that is used to harvest. Now, with every one of those militias, we see a gradual escalation in morality. The Irgun logo, for example, has the words "only thus" inscribed underneath it, indicating that only through mass destruction, annihilation, and war is it possible to accomplish one's goals. And in fact, has the backdrop map not only of historic Palestine, but of Transjordan as well, the area in which the Irgun wishes to continue to spread its morality. And then finally, the Lehi logo, which indicates or shows a two-finger salute. Of course, in addition to sending shockwaves among men over 40, this symbol is a vow to continue this moral campaign to eradicate any and all immorality on the promised land. Every moral army needs morale. Motivation, of course, I mean. not the overly priced indigestible mushroom you find at Michelin star restaurants and your hipster friend's dinner party. Morale lifts spirits and makes the unacceptable not only acceptable, fetishistically desirable. That's why the IDF's moral excellence is complete annihilation of human life in Gaza was boosted tenfold after being told by the Prime Minister Netanyahu that the war isn't actually against Hamas, but rather against the mythical, ahistoric, biblical peoples of Amalek. Who are the Amalek? Does it matter? Did they ever exist? Is there any indication that they are still around? Irrespective, every member of the IDF was encouraged to watch the film 300 and reruns of Game of Thrones for realistic depictions of their adversaries. None of these moral accomplishments could have been possible without such wise leadership, a long history of morality, and a desire to vanquish all those who question this morality. That's all from my end, Bassam.
Thank you very much, Adel, for your incisive address of the morality of the IDF. And I can not stop talking about this, actually, because not only is it a fact, it's an indisputable fact that the IDF is the most moral army in the history of the world. And this is a distinction from the most moral army period, which is shameful to say. It's in the history of the world that it is the most moral army. Even if you try, you cannot dispute it. Pick any metric. Refugee shelters, they blow them up. Schools, they blow them up. Bakeries, they blow them up. Hospitals, they blow them up. Mosques, they blow them up. Churches, they blow them up. City municipalities, they blow them up. Energy reactors of all kinds, they blow them up. Ambulances, they blow them up. Neighborhood, they blow them up. Universities, they blow them up. Children, they blow them up. You name it, the IDF will blow it. They want to blow everything in sight. Who else other than the most moral army in the world can do a better job? I mean, we are consistently surrounded by evidence that the IDF is that moral army, the most moral army in the world. It's all around us. Just watch all the footage you can get your hands on. Do you ever see the IDF actually fighting? They just blow shit up. The Brigadier General Shalit Ibn Shramit, Eban Shramit, revealed the code behind the Israeli acronym IDF, which is commonly thought of as Israel's Defense Forces. But Shalit fessed up that IDF actually stands for I Don't Fight. In all of the footage we see on television, we just see them blowing shit up. We see other people fighting. That's because they're moral. And now that the cat's out of the bag, Shalit announced that the Israeli army is considering changing their acronym from IDF to IBE. I Blow Everything. Insight. Gazans are so taken by the morality of the IDF, they are running into open air and screaming atop their lungs at Israeli drones and jet fighters, blow me next, blow me next. Everyone wants to be blown by the IDF, and not just in Gaza. Yeah. Won't you want the IDF to do that? No one is saying the IDF is perfect, by the way. We're trying to be objective here. Honestly, truth to be told, critics of the IDF are just asking for a lot. What more can the IDF do? First, according to The Onion, the IDF is constantly asking Palestinians to evacuate to nearby bombing sites. Who does that? Why die at home? It's traumatizing to your neighbors. Just walk a few miles to a refugee camp, which is the usually next designated bombing site. Unless you are lucky enough to be blown to pieces by bigger or trigger happy teenage teeny weeny IDF soldiers too impatient to wait. Totally understandable for Gen Z. What's more, Even if you fail to evacuate your neighborhood, the IDF will send a small, cute, little baby Jesus rocket to tap your building before the big mommy rocket completely levels it to the ground. I mean, who does that? Sure, the media with their frivolous superficiality focus on the concept of warning people before they destroy their lives, whatever. I'd like to point something else. I'd like to point your attention to the IDF's unparalleled humanity in not letting the baby Jesus rocket be alone for a long time before its mommy rocket joins it. Yeah. Have you thought about that? Who does that? Israel not only avoids killing actual fighters and combatants while it's busy killing tens of thousands of civilians, the Israeli army also cares about inanimate objects as if they are people. Every baby Jesus rocket is reunited with its mommy rocket in leveling entire neighborhoods. Not only that, of late, those of you who are paying attention and not just watching the mainstream media, to facilitate safe building evacuation, the IDF has also been sending Uber drivers to pick up Palestinians from their homes after they send the cutesy baby rocket. I know what you're thinking. Bassam, stop it. This is ridiculous. I know what you mean. I get it. How would Uber X get to future bombing sites and refugee camps like Jabalia that have been previously bombed to smithereens with two-ton bombs forming 40-foot craters in the ground? Well, that's when the IDF sends the Uber XL. With all of the candy and water you need in the back seat, along with the drivers who speak Arabic with a Palestinian accent to be culturally sensitive. Did the Americans do this in 2003 when they blew the shit out of Iraq? No, they did not. Let's move to our culture landscape expert, Sinan Antoon. If you can please enlighten us about the unending morality of the Israeli army.
Thank you, Bassam. Thank you, Adel. Look, is the Israeli army the most ethical army in the world? Any reasonable human will scream, yes. Even aliens will say, that is, if their existence is not cut short by the IDF, if they're found amongst humans, that it is the most moral army in the universe. Actually, if you search the galaxies, you will not find a more moral army, but haters will hate. Are there a few bad apples? Yes, and Israeli officials themselves will admit that. But why let the actions of 170,000 Israeli soldiers cloud your judgment? Should their errors and minor mistakes tarnish the image of the IDF? I don't think so. Now, as a scholar of culture, whatever that means, I scrutinize language and the production of meaning. And we live in a time of misreading. Those of you who think the IDF is immoral should just pick up a thesaurus to understand why and how you are way off the mark. When you look up moral, you get the following synonyms: square, upright, right, worthy. And if you just disabuse yourselves of your preconceived anti-IDF notion and prejudice, you will come to the conclusion that the IDF is what it says it is. Consistency and transparency are de rigueur. De rigueur is Derrida's cousin, and Derrida is the one who wrote that all readings are misreadings. So let's look at the synonyms. Square. The Israeli army has destroyed thousands of square-like structures and homes in Gaza. It has graciously refrained from destroying any oval-shaped buildings because it's bad luck. The IDF would never bomb pyramids, for example, except if the Egyptian regime stops cooperating. Another synonym for moral is straight. The IDF's barrels and guns are straight. Bullets and bombs go straight to their target, never wavering or zigzagging. No wishy-washy business. Israeli politicians are quite moral and straight. They say they will depopulate Gaza, and they do it. Another synonym is worthy. The weapons supplied by liberal democracies and the very free world are worthy, very worthy. And so the IDF is moral. I recently read a very moving book, the memoirs of a retired Israeli colonel, Sheikh Ahalu Ben Zuna, entitled, "I Killed So Many Palestinians and You Should Too." I highly recommend it. It sheds light on the ethical standards of the IDF. There's so much focus on Gaza. If you step back and look at how the IDF behaved in the past, we'll get a more balanced and objective view. I also think there is a misunderstanding. The Israeli army is the most moral army in the world vis-a-vis its own soldiers. There are many examples. In 2005, according to The Guardian, an Israeli army officer fired the entire magazine of his automatic rifle into a 13-year-old Palestinian girl and then said he would have done the same even if she had been 3 years old. And what happened? Immense kindness and forgiveness was shown, and he was acquitted on all charges by a military court. He said, quote, that anything that's mobile, that moves in the security zone, even if it's a three-year-old, needs to be killed. And afterwards, he burst into tears. Public benches and said, I told you I was innocent. In 2018 in Hebron in the West Bank, a 20-year-old Palestinian, Abdel Fattah al-Sharif, was lying on the ground after being shot along with another Palestinian after allegedly stabbing and wounding a soldier. 11 minutes after the initial shooting, an Israeli soldier and medic named Ilor Azaria walked up to al-Sharif, who was unarmed, barely moving, and shot him in the head. He was sentenced 18 months. The IDF reduced it to 14, citing compassion and consideration for his combat service. It was also wonderful that he was released in time to attend his brother's wedding. The IDF recently showed the world its compassion and superior ethical standards by killing Hadiya Nassar, an elderly Palestinian woman who was older than Israel itself. She was born in 1944. An Israeli sniper, one of the 170,000 bad apples, ended her life with a bullet. Yes, the Israeli army is by all accounts a very moral army. Perhaps as Israelis themselves say, the most moral army. I wonder if they mean that the army is the most moral army in the world and are referring to the Mughal Empire. Anyway, God bless America. It's not enough to send weapons to Israel so it can go on killing innocent civilians. American citizens are sending prayers. I leave you with this.
Hallelujah. I was down there and I got caught up in a vision. Hallelujah. I was down there. And I got caught up in a vision, and I saw what looked like coming out of the heavens, a whirlwind. And it was blowing and going around Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. And it was the glory of God protecting him, preserving him, even though there was a lot of turmoil that was going on around Israel that God is holding off. And so I speak to you, Netanyahu, the Spirit of God declares divine preservation over you, over your health, over your life. For there is those who will say you are not fit to stand in the place that you stand because of health. Yet God shall shift and shake and establish the bulwark that shall stand in the land of Israel. And I see you shall be brought to health and to wholeness. I speak life. I speak longer life. I speak wholeness over you. This I speak to you in Israel, Netanyahu. Be blessed. May the Lord bless you now and keep you. May His face shine upon thee. Be good and be gracious unto you, Netanyahu. And I sipre vumai, and there is a wind that surrounds you. To not only bring but I stivi to previsti borbai, preservation of the hand of God. And I speak this and I say, the thief shall not steal, kill, and destroy. And your life is preserved, and so is what you will join your hands with. And I speak to the turmoil around Israel, of those who seek to harm you, destroy you, you will be exposed. And the plan to strike at you, Israel, shall be foiled before it is launched. I speak this now, and I declare it.
I have no idea how to stop this thing. I'm trying to act cool, but I can't stop it. Maybe it's the glory of God.
It won't go away.
It won't go away. Oh yeah.
It's a miracle.
Divine intervention.
Whatever I do,
the Lord Almighty is responding to the emergency. We invited God to the teaching.
Well,
you're mute. Bassam, you're muted.
Now that we've heard some really impressive people support Israel, the IDF, and of course Netanyahu, do we have any other last words from Sinan, our culture landscape expert, or Adel, our media landscape expert?
I just want to say I feel uplifted. Maybe even beyond this world. I don't know if I will exist anymore after this. Thank you. Thank you to you and the IDF.
Well, with that, I'd like to thank everybody who joined us. Thank you all for working with us to delineate the various aspects of the most oral army or moral army in history, the IDF. Join us later this week with another emergency teaching that will come to you from three Arabs. And Assalamu alaikum and bonsoir.